Once upon a time, a little tiny French boy was born. He had a tiny little smile and a tiny little head. He was very tiny and very cute. The little French boy didn't know that he was the luckiest boy on earth. The luckiest boy in the universe, in fact, because he had something so very special in his family. What he had was the most wonderful and sensational grandma ever. She was truly magnificent and had the biggest heart. The grandma had so much love for so many people, and just when everyone thought that the grandma's heart couldn't stretch any bigger, expand any further, there was more, so much more. She gave the tiny French boy her heart. She couldn't stop kissing him and cuddling him and sniffing his tiny head. 2 years later, another tiny French baby was born. But this one was a beautiful little girl with luscious, lovely lips, all the better to kiss her with. And yet again, the grandma's heart grew and the love that she gave was huge. She would love to buy the little French pair presents, reminding them how much they were loved, and would always help the mummy and daddy out, as two little French babies can be hard work. But to the grandma, they were nothing but joy. 3 years later, while the two little French ones were growing strong and the girl one was showing the boy one who's boss, another lovely little French girl came into the world with the cheekiest grin and the most infectious laugh. Surely the grandma's heart couldn't grow any bigger for this third little bundle of joy. Surely that's not possible. Oh, but yes, this grandma was sent from somewhere very special and could do things that normal humans could not. The grandma loved and loved and loved the third child all over again. But no love was ever spared from all the other people in her heart. People believe that the grandma had magical powers because you never had to ask the grandma for help when you needed a hand, or a hug when you were sad, or a shoulder if you wanted to cry, or listening ears when you needed a chat, or homemade cake when you were hungry. Because the grandma always knew. She would always sense these things. People say it's because the grandma had a special set of eyes, the bluest and the kindest you'll see. But her eyes were different to normal humans, because her eyes could look deep into your heart. So she could see how you felt and what you needed before you even knew yourself. She was magical. She knew that her daughter needed a tiny one too. And sure enough, another little baby was born. A little English one this time. She was another beautiful girl with her grandma's eyes and a smile that stretched her whole face. Her face was the funniest face that the grandma had ever seen and would always make the grandma wet her knickers laughing. The grandma's heart was growing to a humongous size now and was the talk of the village. The flourishing four wondered that if they were to put the grandma's brain under a microscope, would it be made up of tiny little hearts which would each be made up of more little tinier hearts. They were sure it would. So 3 years later, when the fifth baby arrived into the water like a chubby little mermaid, the grandma's heart was more alive than ever, with five fantastic souls to love. This brand new little English girl had the heart and humour of the grandma's first and only love, the granddad. So of course she had space for this one. In actual fact, the fortunate five often wondered where the grandma got her powers from, and they suspected it was something to do with the granddad? Maybe when they held hands in secret, or when the grandma held him really tightly at night, or maybe whilst they slept. Whatever it was, they suspected the granddad knew. They'd often ask him, but he would just shrug his shoulders, wiggle his big hairy eyebrows up and down, and say nothing. Maybe he kept something in those big hairy eyebrows. Did something live in there? Or maybe his giant cuddly tummy was so big because it was holding the grandma's huge heart and he was storing all the love for the grandma. Whatever it was, they knew that this kind of love was the most incredible kind. The grandma would always tell them that they were loved all the world in sixpence. And although the children didn't know what a sixpence was, as this was money from the olden days when the dinosaurs were wandering the streets, they were sure that this was a lot. The fortunate five definitely knew that they had a super special place in Grandma's heart. But sometimes it was difficult for them to know where their family started and ended, as their grandma seemed to love so many and be loved by so many. And might their grandma have been able to use that magic of her ever-expanding heart on her house and kitchen sometimes? As the fortunate five noticed, there was always a bed made and a meal prepared for anyone who needed one. It must have been magic. Sometimes there was even a little old lady who nobody knew on Christmas Day at the dinner table, or an unknown dog or three under the dinner table licking up the crumbs. As the years passed by, the fortunate five were growing beautifully, and the boy began to look more and more like the grandma. She continued encouraging the grandchildren to always be kind, helpful to others, and to always forgive, as people make mistakes, to be patient with everyone. She advised them to be generous to those you love and those that need, to care at all times, even when you need care yourself, because this care will give you the strength through anything. She encouraged the fortunate five that sharing is caring, and it was always important to put others before yourself. Writing a letter, sending a little gift, or making a card was always a lovely way to remind someone that they were in your thoughts and you were thankful for them in your life. The grandma also taught the fortunate five to bake the most delicious cakes and let them know that food is the perfect way to let people know that they are welcome and loved. She let the granddad know this a lot. So one morning in the spring, when the morning birds were singing their morning song, the grandma looked over at her five grandchildren, sees that she has sufficiently transmitted her magical powers, and says to herself, "My work here is done." The fortunate five say, "No, we're not ready. We are only five, and there are so many more hearts to touch." But then the five look around and open their eyes to see another big group of people behind them who have also been infused with the grandma's magic, smiling at them with strength and love. And behind them another, and another, and another, an even bigger group slowly expanding to the multitude of people gathered here on this very day, on whom she has shone her light and infused her power. The grandma's work was indeed complete, and every single person that she had touched was carrying a little bit of her magic in their hearts wherever they went. The fortunate five knew now that they had been blessed with the greatest gift ever, and they knew that whenever they needed her, they would look into their hearts and find her right there, guiding them.